support columns we would need to take out first. We had the spike launcher for that.
You've talked of his desperation, his total acknowledgement of futility. Yet here he was, staying and fighting.
What else was he going to do? If it wasn't today, it was tomorrow, or the day after that. We lost the war, the moment Diaz opened the quarantine zones, the moment Deimos entered our dimension. One way or another, death was coming for us all. But while we still could, we would fight. And right now, we had a checkpoint to defend. It was a simple, straightforward plan, except our VTOL was shot out of the sky. detonated the last support column. We had to get back behind the wall so we could blow the street. Our trigger man got hit. I had to get up there and detonate. We detonated the last support column. We had to get back behind the wall so we could blow the street. We detonated the last support column. We had to get back behind the wall so we could blow the street. We detonated the last support column. We had to get back behind the wall so we could blow the street. Our trigger man got hit. I had to get up there and detonate. We detonated the last support column. We had to get back behind the wall so we could blow the street. We detonated the last support column. We had to get back behind the wall so we could blow the street. Our trigger man got hit. I had to get up there and detonate. We detonated the last support column. We had to get back behind the wall so we could blow the street. We detonated the last support column. We had to get back behind the wall so we could blow the street. We detonated the last support column. We had to get back behind the wall so we could blow the street. Our trigger man got hit. I had to get up there and detonate. I told Hendrix I needed a moment. Good thing Hendrix still had our back. Khalil thanked us. He thought they still had a chance. They had no idea what was about to happen. Egyptian Army Command came over. I gave Hendrix a hand opening the VTOL hatch. I heard screams. We cleared the plaza, but something was wrong. I could hear it. And that was the problem. It This is wrong. This is all wrong. You said opening the gateway would save humanity. It was the only way to defeat Deimos and send him back to Malum. But opening the gateway would let the forces of evil through, allow them to conquer Earth, enslave us. Wait, we didn't meet at Ramsay Station. That didn't happen. You're feeding me false memories.
Be careful, my child. Tread lightly, or you are liable to offend me.
We contacted Khalil, inquired about you. He said you were dead. You died some time ago. I saw you die. When I was with Hall, inside her mind, she showed me the truth. Who are you really, Doctor? Deimos was going to open the gateway. He needed the demons of Malum to enslave Earth for the battle against Dolos. We didn't know what he had planned, but we had Sarah Hall, her signal tracing to Kebeshet.
You didn't think it odd that her signal appeared? After years of absence.
I'd interfaced before. I knew how it worked. It's a memory retrieval, an info dump, a lethal procedure. Darkest thoughts and desires. But this was her deep subconscious. This wasn't supposed to happen.
Because the deep subconscious is more than that. It is the gateway, the portal to Malum. The subconscious hides your fears, your doubts. It's the most primal version of you. It's what you run from. And by running, you persevere in life. But what if you embrace the subconscious? How do you think I opened the gateway?
But you said to open the gateway, I had to relive my memories.
No. I told you to take me to the start of your journey. The journey into the depths of your fears. You chose to relive your memories. So tell me, what do you fear?
Please, why are you doing this? Why are you scrambling my mind? Don't make me do this!
You don't have a choice. You haven't had one since you picked up that child. Since you embrace Sarah's fear. Lead me to the depths. What did Sarah...
Faster.
This Cold War, the Winslow Accord, and common defense...
Paul told me that she had no idea what they were getting into, but they had to follow standard operating procedure, which meant locking down the site and interfacing with the location's primary systems in the server room below. We were built to be invincible. Our DNI let us interface with systems in dangerous environments and upload information. We created the very opportunity for Deimos to leave the server room.
He was a prisoner, with no way to expand humanity's horizon.
We were vehicles for his transportation.
That makes it sound so cold. This is for the good of humanity. Tell me, what did Sarah fear?
Failure. At the Academy, she studied the battles of World War II. The bravery of these men. She feared she could never match their heroism. She feared she didn't have real courage. She ran from it. She had not her subconscious. She gave into fear, let it pull her away. I followed her, deep within her mind. There had to be a way to save her. We heard his voice, Deimos.
Sarah, listen to the sound of my voice. I will have my army and my kingdom. All that remains is her sacrifice.
He was trying to consume her, and he wasn't about to let me stop him. stretched between our dimension and his. She warned me to turn back, to let Deimos take her. I told her I'd stay with her. I'd see it to the end. I asked her what happened after coalescence.
You were deep within her subconscious, at the threshold of another dimension. You seemed to embrace the journey.
You think I wasn't scared? I was terrified. There was no way to make up for what I had done. But I had to try. She was possessed. Hall became a passenger in her own body, a witness unable to intervene as Deimos began using her for his purpose. He wanted them to go to the Black Station. He wanted to find you. He slaughtered the staff. Ravaged them. Why did he kill them?
I wasn't there. He was upset. And he wasn't happy to learn of the documentation of his existence. It was not time for his big reveal, his masterpiece. He was angry. When he found the data drives, he couldn't access them. Part of the drive was missing. He couldn't purge the information as he hoped.
The piece Hendrix and I recovered from the docks. Someone had hidden them from him. Someone knew he would come. Someone was trying to stop him. Deimos didn't want Sarah divulging his secrets to us either. He ripped us from that memory. We were in Foy. I didn't just see fear in Sarah's eyes anymore. I saw admiration. The longer I stayed, the stronger she became. The more she actually believed she had a chance. She told me to follow her. There was something she wanted me to see. Something she wanted to tell me. There was a chapel ahead of us. Hall told me to follow her there. But to get to Hall, we had to get through the Tiger Tank first.
Thank you.
I tried to approach her, but Deimos had other ideas. He was desperate to separate us and evict me from her mind. He wanted her, and I was getting in his way. She told me to approach her. She wanted me to understand.
Sarah couldn't understand. She only saw how it ended. Humans are obsessed with beginnings and ends. The journeys between, they become filler. Life becomes filler. She tried to fight the voice in her head that had given her the ultimate gift.
The ultimate gift? Deimos was controlling her.
Relinquishing control is the ultimate gift. Free of choice. Free of pressure.
You're insane.
No. Humanity is insane. You asked her to help you find Taylor. Where did she take you next?
Deimos needed Taylor to open the gateway, so I had to know. The aquifers. Sarah told me this was their fortress in the sand, their FOB for years. There's something I don't get. You made this happen. You've pushed for the annihilation of Earth. But Deimos wasn't using you. You weren't his puppet. What's in this for you? Why are you doing this? Are you an undead sympathizer?
No, my child. Dr. Salim was not a sympathizer. He was so much less than that. He was so much more insignificant than that.
Was? Wait. What do you mean, was?
I must say, I'm impressed with how delusional you've become. You had completely forgotten this memory.
They found you. They tortured you for information. But this doesn't make any sense. You were an ally. You enabled him, freed him.
Dr. Salim was no ally. He was a tool, an instrument I enabled. He was a blind idealist believing he could make the world a better place. That I could save humanity, that he could save humanity. He thought I'd found him to thank him. Me. A god. Thank a mortal. I found him to seize power from him.
No.
Even now you still hide from the truth. Corvus had been destroyed in Singapore. I needed it to open the gateway. That was why I had kept Salim alive. He worked with a colleague, Kruger. And they built me a new Corvus at Coalescence headquarters in Zurich. One which I could use to open the gateway. So I had no further need for the doctor. She knew.
The tree. I've seen it before. The entrance to Malum.
Tell me, what do you fear? You don't fear the undead. You've thrown yourself against insurmountable odds as if you had a death wish. As if you were trying to escape. Is it failure? Is it life? You fear your mistakes, your past. Your greatest fear is the memory that haunts you.
You awaited her sacrifice. She wanted me to stop you. She wanted me to end it. To deny you her offering. If she offered herself, she'd give you what you wanted. The only way to deny you was to kill her.
You denied me my prize. It was time to send you back to your world. You must know how this ends. This ends with your sacrifice. But now I had you. It wasn't what I was planning. But none of that mattered, because now I had you. But you were strange. I tried to seize control, but something pushed back, something fought me.
They located Taylor. He was being held at Lotus Towers, run by a man named Hakim, an undead.
You know how this ends. You're like the rest of them. Diaz, Moretti, Hall, Taylor. I flow through your veins, slowly grasping control. But you're stronger than I anticipated. Your resistance is greater. But this only makes you all the better for my needs. Lotus Towers. What happened there?
You think I'll help you? After all this?
What real choice do you have in the matter? You're the pawn in my game.
I'm not about to hand over humanity, but I'll humor you. Fine. Let's talk about Lotus Towers. Lotus Tower was one of many megastructures in Cairo. Hakim was the self-appointed slumlord of the Vertical City.
As he asks, give Deimos what he wants. Trust me, it's all
going
to be
okay. We made quick work of Hakim.
Remember the truth.
Khalil spoke to the people. This was their time. Time for the living to take back this city of the dead. Khalil had a mobile shop in place. We could use it to get to the 25th floor. But first, we had to battle our way around the atrium. Once we took the security station and killed the dead system, Cairo Air Support could move in. Maybe we'd have a chance. Or at least give the people a chance. Once we took the security station and killed the dead system, Cairo Air Support could move in. Maybe we'd have a chance. Or at least give the people a chance. Once we took the security station and killed the dead system, Cairo Air Support could move in. Maybe we'd have a chance, or at least give the people a chance. Once we took the security station and killed the dead system, Cairo Air Support could move in. Maybe we'd have a chance, or at least give the people a chance.